You've seen what you can do currently with the NAM. Good spatial resolution, ample temporal resolution, and realistic looking details. Here comes the next update to the NAM. Have you heard of a nest? No, not that kind of nest. A model nest. Inside the larger domain covered by the model, you can place smaller domains, or nests. In this update, we will see 6 available nests that get their input from the larger domain, but don't influence the greater atmosphere around them. CONUS, Alaska, Hawaii, Puerto Rico, and 2 movable high-resolution domains, one each in the CONUS and Alaska. We're talking 1.33-kilometer grid spacing in a domain the size of one of those rectangular western states. Think about the topographic forcing you'll see, the detail that can be attained from grid boxes smaller than a thunderstorm, and having another high-res ensemble member for nowcasting. Astounding! Some of the output fields will be changing too. The most important change for forecasters is how buoyancy is calculated. This affects all buoyancy-related parameters, including CAPE. CAPE is the integral of a parcel's positive buoyancy. When the air parcel is warmer than the environment, it will rise. Until now, the NAM has calculated the air parcel temperature using a dry parcel. Wait! All air parcels contain water vapor. This update replaces dry air temperature with virtual temperature when calculating buoyancy. TV is always greater than T, so CAPE will be greater everywhere. In some places, the increase will be as much as 15% to 20%. CAPE will also increase in aerial coverage. This means more forecast grids with convective potential. Another output field affected by this NAM update is reflectivity. In strong convective events, NAM simulated reflectivity was often lower than radar reflectivity. Model drop sizes were too small. Now, drop sizes can double in size, increasing simulated reflectivity. In the updated precipitation scheme, the bulk of the precipitation now occurs earlier in an event. So 1-hour forecasts of accumulated precipitation should give you better guidance on short, heavy precipitation events. Although drops are larger and precipitation is front-loaded, the total accumulation will be similar. So in this update, we'll get increased horizontal resolution with 6 nests, more accurate CAPE and SIN values, and better guidance for short, heavy precip events. This will make the NAM output more useful in preparing your forecasts.